get ready to match the stars from the Love Boat, Ted Land, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, from Dallas, Audrey Lander, McLean Stevenson, and from Harbor Valley PTA, Edie McClurg, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game. And now, here's the star of Match Game, Gene Rayburn.
Okay, that's the way you feel about it. Are you quite ready?
Yes.
Yes. All right, let's get right to it by saying hello to Elsa Blasky and Ed Sylvester. You remember Elsa? She's married to the Polish princess. Were you born in Puerto Rico?
Yes, I was.
And where do you live?
In Tuscany.
A Polish prince, I beg your pardon.
Be very careful.
We won't go into the psychology of that slip.
That's a Freudian slip, if I've ever heard one. Anyway, where did you say you were from again?
Tustin, California.
You grew up there?
No.
No.
No, I didn't grow up there.
Where'd you grow up?
In Puerto Rico.
Oh, all right, Elsa. And Ed Sylvester lives in the San Diego region, do you?
Right, San Diego.
And, listen, you don't have to wear your pass. And, I mean, we all know you're in the building, and you're Ed Sylvester, and you're okay. I mean, you're not a security risk, are you?
I guess I'm a weirdo.
Yeah, I think I'm going to have to frisk you. Shall I frisk him? Or would you like to frisk him? All right, let's get on with it here now. Where are we? In the middle of round one, game two. And she's had her question. This is yours. Question A says, Tim said, television is too violent. I just saw 7 robberies, 3 murders, and a beating, and that was on blank. All right, here we go. Tim said, television is too violent. I just saw 7 robberies, 3 murders, and a beating, and that was on blank.
On a commercial.
On a commercial. All right. On a commercial, he said. What do you say?
On a commercial.
On a commercial.
Ah, yeah, that would mean that the commercials are also violent.
Right.
I said...
Aha! There's one for him.
Oh, Ed,
very
we're
good.
We're imperfect, too. Commercial.
Commercial. Let's do those.
Spelt wrong, Sesame Street.
Sesame Street. An excellent response, however. 2 for Ed so far. Audrey, just saw 7 robberies, 3 murders, and a beating, and that was on what?
Captain Kangaroo.
Captain Kangaroo, another good answer. Don, don't boo that answer. That's good. McLean, what have you got?
One of my favorites, The Oral Roberts Show.
Aha! And what's your favorite, Edie?
Well, it's a beautiful day in my neighborhood. They stole my dog and took my goods on Mr. Rogers.
Mr. Rogers, neighborhood. All right, we got some goodies there. 2 for him. We go to round 2, and Ed, you're ahead. Remember, the rule says you have to go first if you're ahead in round 2.
Yeah, I'll go with A.
A, 4 people play, Charles in the lower tier. Sid said, you know you're at a really sleazy restaurant when the waitress is wearing a hairnet on her blank. All right, here we go. Ed.
Bill.
Sid said, you know you're at a really sleazy restaurant when the waitress is wearing a hairnet on her blank.
On her nose.
On her nose?
On her nose.
She had a hairy nose.
Hairy nose.
Hairy nose. What do you say, Charles?
Chuck said face.
On her face.
Right on.
All right, that's one. Face is a good response. Audrey, wearing a hairnet on her.
Well, this was a really sleazy place, and she was sleazy, and she had a mustache.
Hairnet on a hairnet on her mustache. What do you say, McLean?
Well, I guess since your nose is on your face and your mustache would be under your nose, I'm going to get honked on this. I said your face.
Face. Right.
See, I told you.
Right. Very good intuition.
Yeah.
Miss Edie.
Well, it was in the singular, but I went for the plural. I went for the region where women should but don't sometimes and don't.
A foreigner, no doubt.
No. Oh. Oh.
See, this man's kind of
funny. Now, are you gonna get letter?
No.
That one.
That's their crazy custom. Elsa, you need two to tie and three to win. Are you ready?
Come on.
Listen carefully. Jim said, this weather is really terrible. We need this weather like blank needs elevator shoes. You know what elevator shoes are?
Yes.
All right with you?
Why don't you look up at home tonight? Leave us out of it. Jim said, this weather is really terrible. We need this weather like blank needs elevator shoes.
A giraffe.
A giraffe? We were thinking of any tall person. Not, there was no reference to an animal in there. I don't know why you said giraffe, my dear. What do you
say? You know, well, I'm glad you said it myself. Because we were really, you know, I went backwards. I did it the wrong way.
Well, you named a short person?
Yes, instead of a tall person, which is...
Oh.
But we will give you this anyway, because right. I like this guy, and I haven't seen him in a while, and I think he should be mentioned. Paul Williams.
He'd love it.
Yes.
He'd be very
good
happy.
Good man, good man.
He is indeed.
Oh, I just talked to him on the telephone. Wilt Chamberlain, I believe, is going to be the...
A tall person. Any tall person.
Wilt Chamberlain.
Hey. Wilt the Stilt Chamberlain is the way they used to refer to him. We need this... This weather is really terrible. We need this weather like blank needs elevator shoes.
Well, I thought of a very tall person. I had the Jolly Green Giant.
Another tall person? Now you got to match the two remaining ones to stay in the game and achieve a tie.
Yeah, well, it always seems to me to be saying goodbye to the princess.
Oh, you're going to say goodbye, princess?
Yeah,
Princess Pulaski.
Goodbye, Elsa. I put King Kong.
King Kong. All right, Ed wins it. Kareem Abdul-Jabbar. Yeah, very good, Edie. We're going to send some prizes to Elsa Pulaski. We're going to send you a bag of headaches and all kinds of wonderful things will be coming your way. Thank you for being with us
here
on Match Game. Elsa, we'll spin her off and spin a message for America. Hurry back. Ed Sylvester now has $5,500, and here's his second chance at earning a lot of money. Let's see how he does with this big super match. We polled an audience, said write down your best response to this. What a nice blank. What a nice blank. All right, three of the six. Look at the ones you think have a good answer and pick them out one at a time.
Okay, I'd like to ask Audrey.
What a nice girl.
What a nice girl.
Okay, Charles.
What a nice day.
All right.
Brett.
What a nice man.
What a nice man, what a nice girl, what a nice day. Those are the three. Do you want one of those or one of your own?
Hard.
No, I'll go with day.
What a nice day.
That was my first thought, Ed.
What a nice day is what he's after. Let's see if it's up there. May we see the bottom one, please? What a nice body.
Oh, they had a younger crowd here that day.
It's very forward.
Yes, it is forward, quite. But an interesting thought. Let's see the next one, please.
Nice.
Nice smile. So far... You got nothing that they gave you. Nothing. All right, let's go to the top and look at the big one. Day. Atta boy. Very good, Chuck. Now, again, Ed, you've got another $500. Means you have an even $6,000 at this moment. Again, you're going to spin the wheel, and we'll see how you do. Let's all root for a double for Ed. Here we go. Here we go. Good luck to you. Tales of blank. There it is, T-A-L-E-S of blank. All right, sir. Think about it. All right, your job is a match, Ted. If you do that, you get the $5,000. How do you fill in that blank?
Tales of horror.
Tales of horror. Tales of horror is a good one. All right, Ted said. He said tales of horror. What do you say?
I said tales of the Brothers Grimm.
Tales of the Brothers Grimm.
Yes, and this is very grim.
Right. Tales of Hoffman was the first thing that came to my mind. I don't know why. Anyway, listen,
tales
Ed, you haven't done too bad. You've got $6,000. Congratulations to Ed Sylvester. will welcome Barbara Dixon and Karen Bugmorto. Welcome, ladies. Karen, say your name for us.
Nobumoto.
Oh, that's what I said, Nobumoto. Where are you from?
Laguna Beach, California.
Where did the name Nobumoto come from?
My father's Japanese.
Oh, I see. What do you do?
I'm in computer sales.
Uh-huh. Where do you do that?
In Orange County.
All right. You ready?
Yes.
Good luck to you, Karen.
Thank you.
Barbara, tell us about you, please.
Well, I'm originally from England, but I just moved here from upstate New York.
Right. What town?
Albany, the capital.
Right. You ready?
I'm ready.
Okay, ladies. I guess you're both ready. So we'll ask Karen to make her selection, A or B.
A, please.
All right. A it is for her. Professor Screwloose just invented the world's worst auto accessory. After a collision, the car radio plays blank. World's worst auto accessory. Karen. Professor Screwloose just invented the world's worst auto accessory. After a collision, the car radio plays blank.
Sayonara, goodbye.
Sayonara. That's okay. That's a good one. You got the idea.
That's real good.
Yeah, sayonara. Goodbye.
Black woman gives Japanese answer. Very good.
In former seat of Polish Puerto Rican princess.
Right, right. Correct.
No, yes. What I did was I said the car radio plays, thanks for the memories.
Aha!
Da 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 da.
All right.
Da 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 da.
Yes, ma'am.
I said it plays funeral music. In the dirge.
All right, little funeral dirge. It's not bad. What do you say,
it
Chuck?
It plays that popular song, So Long, It's Been Good to Know You.
Aha. Uh-huh. So long, it's been good to know you. All right, Audrey. The world's worst auto accessory invented by Professor Screwloose. After a collision, the car radio plays...
Take good care of yourself. You belong to me.
Boop, boop, ba-doop.
All right. Would you like to do a chorus or something for us, McLean?
Yes. The song that I have selected is what we call in the trades a bullet, going right through the top of the charts, as they say. It's a new one.
A new one.
A lot of people won't be too familiar with it. It's, I think, going to be a big hit. Pat Boone did. It's called Dead. It's like I say, it's new, and a lot of people...
Yeah, right. Okay. After a collision, the car radio plays Dead.
That's one of those things you just whistle all day once you hear it.
Right. You want to give us a sample of it?
Sure.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Catchy little tune.
Yeah.
I think they'll be walking out of the theater here, studio here, singing that song. All right, Edie, a little fast chorus from you?
Yeah, well, Charles and I were on the same wavelength. So long, it's been good to know you. So long, it's been good to know you.
Cut, get the hook out. All right, where are we here? We're in the middle of round one. You'll have a question in a moment or so. Right now, this for you.
And here again, the star of our show, Gene Rayburn.
Thank you, John. Ready, Barbara?
Ready.
Okay, here we go. Jimmy said, you know the weather is really cold when you come home and your wife is filling a blank with antifreeze. It's really cold. Home and find your wife filling the blank with antifreeze. Ready, Ted? Jimmy said, you know the weather is really cold when you come home and your wife is filling the blank with antifreeze.
The bathtub?
The bathtub? All
that's
right.
That's good. What else? That's a good answer.
I think we're on our way to a scoreless tie, folks.
That's not real bad.
What do you say?
That's not real bad. It's just not real great.
Right.
A little thought there. I said coffee pot.
The coffee pot?
Yeah.
You are a weirdo, aren't you,
Ted? Warm inside. Are you kidding?
Okay. All right, Brett.
No, it was so cold that the bourbon froze. We put it in the bourbon bottle.
Filling the bourbon bottle with antifreeze. Well, that's the way your mind runs, friends.
The cocktail shaker.
The cocktail
that's
shaker.
That's no better than this.
All right. No one understands me anymore, friends. You know the weather's really cold. You come home, your wife is filling the blank with antifreeze. Give us a good answer.
It's very cold. I thought the oven.
I don't think any of us got this question.
Now, you see, there's a good example of not criticizing our contestants. The poor lady just got here from England. The other one looks like she swallowed an Erector set. And so far, we've come up with nothing.
That's true. For either one of them.
Exactly.
Give
so
her
that's
something.
Why I said brass monkey. Think about it, folks.
Yeah, right. No, that's a good response.
Okay.
Okay, Edie.
Okay, I'm dealing in the realm of reality now.
Right.
Okay.
Hey, welcome
in
back.
In northern Wisconsin, where my folks have their summer place, they have to, when they leave, fill the toilet with antifreeze.
That's right. Because it gets really cold up there. Really cold. Well, rolling along here, we go to round two, the final round, and since it's a scoreless tie and she went first last time, you go first this time, Barbara.
I'll go with B.
All right.
We want to know what you would have said.
What you would have said to that question. What was your answer to
that question?
So cold.
I would have said, it's so cold outside, you come home, you find your wife filling the kid with antifreeze.
Oh,
the dog. Filling the dog. Savages are hostile.
Charles.
Hostile savages in this audience there.
Water bottle, hot water bottle.
That was a mindless question.
Yes, it was a mindless question. Gary said, this town is really wild. Sorry, I can't wait for you. Today, the local church raffled off a blank. That's how wild this town is.
Isn't that interesting?
You ever wear a silk shirt?
No, never have.
Silk pajamas?
One time, but couldn't handle it.
Gary said, this town is really wild. Today, the local church raffled off a blank.
Lady of the evening.
Lady of the evening.
That's good.
That's wild. That's a wild
that's
town.
That's real wild.
You moving?
What's the name of that town? I said sheriff, though.
Hey, sheriff. All right, a good response. What do you say?
Well, now, this may be a match. I said the local rug maker or hooker.
Oh, yeah, that's close enough. There's one to Barbara.
I think this is a match. A night at Flora's place in the Red Light District next to the car wash across from the general store on the other side of the track.
All right, give it to him. I don't want to argue with him. Give it to him. That's two for Barbara. Audrey, really wild town. The local church raffled off a what?
Lady of the night.
All right, that's three for her. Is that the way your mind runs?
Yeah, I just took the edge off a little. I said a 92-year-old hooker.
Great.
Well, McLean, I left the edge on. I put it straight out there, and I just said a hooker.
A hooker. Yeah. Okay, well, you did pretty good with that. Five for you. You got some catching up to do. Now this for you. Hello there. In accordance with Brett's request, we got the dictionary out, and we're looking for the word sleazy. An adjective, origin unknown. One first definition, A, lacking firmness of texture. Flimsy, B, carelessly made of inferior materials. Shoddy. Two, second definition, marked by cheapness of character or quality. The synonym for that, it says C, limp. I think we ought to stop right here.
All the sleazy people.
Cut the dictionary tag.
I think maybe I should have gone and just looked it up in my own dictionary, but thanks.
I told you to look it up yourself and not bother me.
I'll blow it out your ear.
All the sleazy people have left the stage, and all the classy people are still here.
I think it was so interesting for our audience, and I think that this should go on PBS soon. God knows we've been on every other station. still with you.
Have we got an ending for this, Charles?
No. Right. But maybe that big red
book. Don't come back. We don't need you. We're doing well without you.
Maybe the big red book could help us out.
Join us next time for the Match Game. Goodbye.
Today's contestants will also receive
an assortment of Crayola products with everything children need for hours of imaginative play. Fun to create with Crayola. Maintain your furniture's natural beauty with Guardsman Furniture Polish, recommended by manufacturers of fine furniture. Guardsman, the finishing touch for fine furniture. New Purina Moist and Chunky tastes better, costs less than the leading competitor. Moist and Chunky dog food, better taste, lower price. When you got anything that sticks or squeaks, reach for WD-40. Makes things work smoother, last longer. Do it yourself with WD-40.
A Mark Goodson, Bill Totman production. Program is edited for broadcast.